In this tutorial, you will discover how to use SwiftUI to compose a list of messages out of a sample data, layout fields, and modifiers. Specifically, you will be designing this layout clone of the iOS Messages app's contact list. Hi, my name is Amos, design advocate at Stream. I have divided this video into four steps. We will begin by touring the sample data. Next, I'll show you how to bring the sample data into the UI. Next, we will define the layout tree using a diagram. And finally, we will be composing the contact list. So let's get started. Let's begin with the layout tree, that is the structure of the page. You can see all the views on the page are contained in this root parent container, which is a VStack, that is a vertical container. It contains two main views. So we have the navigation view, which consists of the search bar and a header. Then we have the list. The list also has a horizontal container, that is each row. So in each row, we have the status, with the first one marked with this blue circle. That indicates the message is not read. So when the message is read, we show another circle with opacity set to zero, so you don't see that circle at all. Next, we have the user avatar. Then we have another vertical container that contains the message summary and a row which consists of the name and the timestamp. Let's move on to the next, the data storage. Here we have the structure of the data we will be using to populate the UI. I have defined the struct message structure and made it identifiable. Using this protocol, we make it possible to use value types that needs to have a stable notion of identity. The only requirement for the identifiable protocol is the UUID, which is a universally unique identifier, which helps to identify the data fields and types. So over here, we have all these fields which we want to use to populate the list. Next, we have the sample data. Here, I have created an array which holds all the fields. So we have the unread indicator, the user avatar, name, message summary, and also the timestamp. Let's now go to the file message view and start creating the layout. You can see here I have created this basic structure message view. To bring the data from the data model to this file, we create an empty array messages. And to be able to see the data in the preview, we pass the array messages and the data we defined in the data model. So let's begin creating the UI, starting from the main container, which is this root container, that is the VStack. Let's command click the text and embed in a VStack. We will start to create the navigation view, which consists of the search bar and a header. I've already created the search bar. So when we go to components, you can see we have the search bar view. So we can bring this content into this file using the file name. I'm going to remove the text and put search bar. Since this belongs to the navigation, we are going to embed it in the navigation view. Let's give the navigation view a face height of 80 using the frame modifier. We don't need the width, so I'm going to select this and delete. And also remove the alignment. We now don't see anything on the screen, but let's give the navigation a title. We can do that by using the navigation title modifier. Let's put messages. Next, we want to add two items to the navigation. We can do this using the navigation bar items. That takes two parameters, leading and trailing. So the leading parameter is the items you want to put on the left. The trailing parameter puts the items on the right. So for the leading view, we are going to use a button that is an edit button. So I'm going to paste again and replace the view. You can see we have the same button, edit, at both edges. But for the one on the trailing, we want to use an SF symbol. So let's remove this one and use a label for the SF symbol. Let's bring the SF symbol application and search for pencil. I'm going to use this one. By selecting the icon, we can press Shift, Command, and C to copy its name. Then over here, I'm going to paste it. So we have changed that to this pencil icon. Next, let's make the title of the navigation to be in line with the buttons. We can do this with the modifier called Navigation Bar Title Display Mode and set it to inline. So over here, I'm going to add that. And that gives a smaller navigation title in line with the buttons we just defined. Let's move on to create the list. I'm going to select the root container, which is the vertical container, and bring the list view. For the list, we are going to pass the empty array we defined here. Then over here, we have to use item in. That creates this empty rectangle that occupies the entire width and height of the remaining part of the screen. Inside the list, we are going to compose all the views. So let's bring the structure again. We are going to begin with the status. So the root container in the list is this horizontal parent container, which contains the status avatar and also another vertical container. So we are going to start with this H stack. Let's create an image view and add the onRed indicator, which is stored in the database. So let's go back to the data model. You can see we have the field onRed indicator. So I'm going to pass this to the image. So let's put item and then paste the name. So we now have the list, and anywhere the message is onRed, we show the onRed indicator. Since we want to display the items in a row, we can select this one and embed in an H stack. So the next field to bring is the user avatar, as you can see here. So let's copy this image and paste it below. Then we change the name to the field avatar. So as you can see, we have pulled all the images. Let's begin to style the images. The first thing to do here is to make the image resizable so that we can modify the image as we want using the resizable modifier. Next, we want to convert each one to a circle image. We can do this using the clip shape modifier. The clipping shape will be a circle. So you can see we have converted each one of them to a circle. The next thing is to give each of the images a fixed width and height. We can do this using the frame modifier. So I'm going to set the width to 45 and the height to 45 as well. Then I'm going to remove the alignment. So the images are not in line because of this onRed indicator. So when a message is read, let's add another image so that it will be in line with the blue circle. I'm going to define a color over here using color literal. Let's change this to, for example, any color we want. Then I'm going to embed the image in a Z-Stack container so that we can place another content in front or at the back of this image. So at the back of the onRed indicator, we are going to put the red indicator. You can see that aligns the images, but this is not what we want to use. I'm going to set this as the same size as the onRed indicator, which has a width and height of 11. So I'm going to copy this frame modifier and paste it here. Then I'll change the size to 11. So we have all the images in line. We now show the on red indicator and also the red indicator. We don't want to see this at all. So let's open the color picker. By going to order, we can set the opacity to 0. So when a message is read, we don't see that indicator at all. So we only see the blue circle, which indicates the message hasn't been read. Let's move on to the next. The next has a vertical container that contains the name, timestamp, and the message summary. So below the avatar, I'm going to add a vertical container. Inside the vertical container, let's start from the one on top, the name and the timestamp, which is a horizontal container. So I'm going to copy this VStack and paste it here. And then I'll change this to HStack. Inside the HStack, we are going to bring the name. We can do this using a text view. So for the text, we are going to pass the name that is stored in the database, which is this one. So when we go to the sample data, you can see we have stored each of the names over here. So by using a backslash and parentheses, I'm going to put item and name. And that brings all the names. The next item in the horizontal container is this timestamp and the right arrow. That is also embedded in a horizontal container. So let's copy this horizontal container and paste it over here. So for this one, we are going to use the timestamp, which is also stored in the database. Let's change the font to headline. You can see I mistakenly placed the timestamp in the VStack instead of the HStack. So I'm going to remove it from here. Then I'll put it inside this HStack. And that shows in line with the name. Next, we are going to display the arrow. We can do this using an SF symbol. So I'm going to bring the SF symbol application and search for chevron. We can use this one, chevron forward. I'm going to press Shift, Command, and C to copy its name. Then over here, I'm going to add an image. So let's paste the name here. So we have the right arrow showing just after the timestamp. Let's go back to the structure again. You can see the name and the timestamp are far apart, and we have this white space between them. We can achieve this using a spacer. So just after the name, I'm going to put a spacer. And that pushes the name and the timestamp further apart. Let's also change the foreground color of all the items in this horizontal container. So I'm going to select it, and where it ends, I'm going to add the foreground color modifier and use secondary. And that makes the text gray. Next, in the vertical container, which is this one, I'm going to add the message summary. So let's select the VStack. And inside that, we are going to add the summary of messages using a text view. Let's copy this text view and replace this one. And then we change the name to message summary, which is also stored in the database. Let's also change the foreground color of the message summary to the same color as the timestamp and the name, which is this secondary color. For the font, we will also change it to headline. By embedding the content in a list, we get this automatic scrolling behavior. Let's go back to the preview again. You can see the list doesn't have the background. We can achieve the same thing using the list style modifier in SwiftUI. Let's go to where we have the list. Over here, I'm going to add the list style modifier. We have several options. I'm going to use plain. When you look closely, you can see the names are not aligned with the message summary. Let's align that using the alignment parameter in the VStack. So over here, I'm going to pass the alignment parameter and set it to the left, which is the leading part of the view. And this is all we need to do in this video. We created the message list out of a sample data, layout views, and modifiers. Thanks for watching.